We are at an extraordinary time in the history of both humanity and Earth, in that since the Industrial Revolution, we have now, post-1950, our activities as an industrial society, driven by this great story we tell ourselves, and all civilizations have a great story they tell themselves. Ours is this suicidal one of economic rationalism, growth for the sake of growth, which means endless destruction. And so, particularly, say, 1960s and 70s on, that activity of destroying forests, increasing the area of deserts, 40% of the world suitable for agriculture is now desert, pumping up a carbon, you know, through burning of coal and fossil fuel. We have this extraordinary Earth with its 9 interrelated systems that sustains this sort of very thin layer, a film, if you like, around our planet that sustains these conditions for life. Our behaviour post-Second World War has destabilised all of those 9 systems.
Back through history over the last 10,000 years or so, you will find civilizations that have collapsed all over the world. And they generally collapse when agriculture collapses. And the root cause of all civilization collapses is environmental damage. So it's damage to the water cycle, the hydrological cycle, it's erosion, it's land degradation, it's loss of food production. Often that then leads to things like civil wars and famines and diseases and so on, which finishes things off. But the root cause is environmental damage. This is reality. We're on a trajectory to nowhere right now, and as a human race.
People wonder why we have tree dieback. Well, a big part of that is the lack of ground cover. There's a balance that we've got to try and learn.
It's more complicated than we can nearly comprehend. New England dieback was caused from the imbalance. I think the main thing is that we recognise it's complex.
The only thing that's going to save us is the holism of regenerative agriculture. You could see that as the next phase, for want of a better word, the new organic revolution, where we do, if you like, that full circle, like the indigenous organic mind, back to where we see ourselves as not surviving without nurturing the substrate that sustains us, which is Mother Earth and her systems. And whether we're going to do that in time, as we gallop into the Anthropocene, is the question before us. But we have to cling to hope, and the big hope I see is this new movement of regenerative agriculture, understanding of earth system science, and bringing a partnership with the urban consumer and the urban people that are getting into, you know, sustainable energy and better food, healthier food and all that sort of thing.
It will change before it reaches disaster. What the human race tends to do is go right to the brink, almost of total collapse, before it will change.